It's reported that there has been a massive alien invasion in the streets of India, and we here at CRA have managed to grab hold of it and get it right to our viewers. This machine out here looks like it has come all the way down here to India from the movie Transformers. Man, look at it. It's so nicely and neatly crafted. Starting with the headlight, you get 4 LED lights, even the DRLs are LED, you get upside down forks, you get all new brake discs which is directly carried away from the RC390, and you also get the same braking setup which is better enough, and you get a better braking bite with this unit. Even the wheel rims have made light. You get a larger 15 liter metal fuel tank which will reduce your fuel stops when you are touring. You get a brand new engine, that is 399cc liquid cooled DOHC fuel injected engine which makes up to 46 PS of power and 39 Newton meters of torque. This bike is lighter now and more faster. This time around you get adjustable clutch as well as the brake lever to set your reach. The seats are well padded and makes you feel comfortable. Talking about the chassis, you have 2 different frames, that is like the front part you get a steel subframe wherein the rear end is of aluminium. Talking about the suspension, the monoshock has been mounted on the side to make room for a bigger airbox as well as increased ground clearance. You get an all new underbelly exhaust. But to be honest, I'm not a fan of the sound. Talking about the instrument cluster, you get an all new TFT display which is really intuitive, and you have lots of menu options to select with. So talking about the options, when you go to motorcycle, you can select the ride mode. You can select it into either street, rain, or you get a dedicated track mode in this. And then you can switch off and on the ABS. Actually, you cannot switch off the ABS, but you can switch off the rear ABS in the supermoto mode. And you also can play around with traction control, and you also get cornering ABS in this machine. For the adrenaline junkies who want to use their machine out there on the track and hit frequent track days, you have a perfect traction machine out here. You get launch control which gets enabled when you hit the track map. But then what I felt, that they should have given little more room in the front part so that you can move around, or when you are tucking in you can sit back, because when I was doing high speed I was sitting on the rear seat. Yes, I'm slim or I'm fit, but then for healthy riders I think that might be a major problem what they might face. Talking about the design, you get lot of sharp edges which looks decent, and yes, it depends on individual the way they accept it. There are mixed reviews based on its design, but for me personally, I am in love with this machine. So we put this machine to test in based on 3 different aspects. The first one was the busy traffic roads. Surprisingly, this engine did not heat up like the way the RC390 was heating up, because this is an all new engine which is 390cc liquid cooled, and even it gets the curved radiator wherein the heat gets dissipated very smartly, very brilliantly, so that you cannot feel it in your thighs. And then maneuvering it in the traffic was so easy, and the change in direction was so quick. This machine with the shorter wheelbase makes you feel more committed to the machine. On the highways, the ride was plush and there was decent amount of wind blast managed up till 140, but then past 140 kilometers per hour there is nothing to stop it, because even if you tuck in like this, the wind directly hits your shoulders, making you feel unstable and uncomfortable. And yes, this is the street naked and you cannot complain on that part. So you can easily cruise in the speed of 140 km per hour because that is the sweet spot of this machine. This is a high revving machine, so you can easily clock 160 plus. Given that you are safe and you are wearing all your riding gears, because this machine is built to give you all the thrills what you can churn up from a Super Sport 400cc segment bike. Unfortunately, we had only limited time to spend with this machine, so we couldn't take this machine out on the track. But trust me, without taking this to the track, I can give a statement saying that this machine would be fun at track. This machine checks all the boxes. Your everyday commute, check. Your weekend rides, check. If you want to go out for small exploration, check. If you want to plan a Ladakh trip, even this checks that box, because the new ground clearance has been increased and doing mild off-road is not a big headache anymore. With the pros, this also has cons that is like not majorly noticeable, but they are to be considered. That is the quick shifter. So the quick shifter is not that slick, or the issues with the quick shifter or the glitch with that has to be sorted. And if they would have given little room to play around here, that would have made the machine serve all the purpose. And then comes the tires. The tires are the main, you know, drawback of this machine, because it does not boost your confidence when you're doing high speed or when you're attacking a corner. So if these issues are sorted, this would get 10 out of 10. And trust me, if given a chance, I would buy this machine right now, because I am in love with it for the complete package it offers and for the thrill it offers and for its looks. So being said that, we would rate this mean looking machine 9 out of 10 for its look, for all the upgrades it has got, especially thanks to KTM for bringing this fully adjustable WP Apex open cartridge fork, so that you can play around a lot with the suspension settings and you know, get the right setting for right terrain. Stay tuned to CRM Motorsports for more contents on racing as well as motorsports. And if racing is your dream, join CRM Motorsports.